Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be discussing about IoT characteristics, that is also referred as features of IoT system. So first, I'll be listing all the characteristics of IoT, then each and every characteristics that I'll explain you in great detail. So first, I'll be discussing about how connectivity is there with IoT. Then I'll explain you how sensing and perception is happening in IoT. Then I'll explain you how dynamic and self-adapting is happening in IoT system, how self-configuration that is happening in IoT system. Then I'll explain you how we can have interoperable communication protocols in IoT system. Then we'll be discussing about unique identity of each devices in IoT system. Then I'll explain you how heterogeneity is there with IoT system. Then I'll explain you integrated into information network in IoT system. Then I'll explain you scalability of IoT system. Then I'll explain you how security and privacy matters in IoT system. And at last, I'll be discussing about automation and control feature of IoT system. So let us start with first characteristic, that is connectivity of IoT system. See, when it comes to connectivity, you should know here we are connecting IoT devices with internet. So based on range, there are varieties of protocols that is available, right? You may have a need of short range communication. You may have a need of long range communication. You may have a need of medium range communication. Based on that, different protocols are available. So connectivity, that is the major essential part of IoT system, as all the IoT devices are connected with each other with the use of internet, right? So connectivity explains interconnection of all IoT devices. Here, uninterrupted connection at any time, anywhere with any IoT device matters a lot. The reason is, in real time, all the devices are providing data on internet. That is what entire IoT system. So at any time means in real time, at anywhere means location doesn't matter. Any device should be able to communicate with each other. Based on that, one can have real time application, right? So connectivity matters a lot in IoT system, that you can say. Here, now I'll give you some basic case study, or you can say example. See, connection of IoT device with internet, that matters over here. Sometimes connection of IoT device with gateway, that also comes into the picture. So when I have explained IoT structure, at that time I have explained how interconnection of devices is happening with gateway, as well as how IoT devices are providing data to internet, right? So all those things that we have discussed in its structure, right now you should know connectivity that is happening as per devices are communicating with gateway, as well as devices are also providing same data, same information on internet. So you can say devices are things, and we are connecting all the devices on internet, means this is Internet of Things, right? Now let us try to understand how sensing and perception is happening. See, in devices, there will be sensors and actuators. When it comes to sensors, it is used to sense physical entity. Like as if you want to measure a temperature, you will be having temperature sensor. If you want to measure moisture, you will be having moisture sensor. If you want to measure speed, you will be having speed sensor. Likewise, varieties of sensors are integrated in embedded system, right? And to respond to the situation, you will be having actuators. But to respond to the situation, some perception should be there. So that perception is created based on algorithms and programs, right? So algorithms and programs, those are available on IoT cloud, as well as those can be developed on internet. And based on that, perception is created. Perception means if some input is given to you, then based on that input, what should be the response of given system? So to give response, we will be having actuators, right? So here, see, IoT devices are equipped with sensors, actuator, and embedded system, where sensors will be sensing data, or you can say physical entity, right? Physical entity could be anything. Based on the requirement, we will be sensing the data. Actuator will be providing real-time response, right? Now, I'll be explaining you dynamic and self-adapting of IoT system. See, IoT system should be dynamic and it should be self-adapting. Why? The reason is, with respect to situation, devices will have to adapt. Let me give you an example. See, for example, if you talk about camera. So at daytime, camera will be functioning in normal mode. But at night time, mode should get changed automatically. Right? So in that, there will be night vision mode that will be available. But that should get adapt automatically. For that, it is not like there has to have manual control. Right? So that is how IoT system that should be dynamic and self-adapt. Let us try to understand that in more detail. So here, see, adaptability to changing context is more essential. So based on context, adaptability should be there. Like, it should be based on operating conditions, it should be based on user's context, and it could be based on sensed environment. So these are the context by which adaptability that should be there with IoT devices, right? See, if I talk about one example like surveillance system, so in that there can be day and night mode, as I have told. During daytime, it should be having normal mode. At night time, if it is there in normal mode, then nothing will be visible. So in that situation, there will be night mode, right, in which it will be, it can detect energy of motion and energy of graphics, right? See, sometimes you may need to understand things in some other context as well. If you talk about how much size of video is there, then with raw file, size will be very large. So in majority of times, you'll be observing in video data, we capture only motion. We capture only motion. So with system, sometimes we provide such intelligence in which we just try to capture motions, right? So see, capture motion with the movement, right? That is what also a concern which comes under self-adapting, right? Now, I'll be going to explain you next characteristic, that is self-configuring. See, self-configuration is very, very essential to make system automatic. The reason is, sometimes your device may be there in one mode. Now, before it gets switches to another mode, there has to have a need of configuration. See, adaption is a different thing. Before you adapt to the situation, you will have to configure the device. The reason is, we are talking about embedded devices over here, right? So before devices are getting switched to another mode, there has to have configuration, right? So self-configuration, that is also essential parameter with IoT system. See, self-configuration means ability to change operating parameters based on ongoing situation, right? See, here we need to have configuration of devices by themselves with respect to different situation. Now, I'll be explaining you interoperable communication protocols. See, here, when it comes to IoT system, you need to understand this in this way. So many IoT devices are there. Those IoT devices are communicating with one gateway. Now, gateway is also communicating with internet. Even sometimes, IoT devices are also communicating with each other, right? So, varieties of communication is happening. Some communication are short range, some communication are direct, some communication are happening after conversion, right? So, it is very, very essential that here there has to have interoperable communication. Interoperable means different protocols can get translated when the data is getting exchanged in between nodes, right? So, here, IoT can support varieties of communication protocols. IoT operates at different communication protocol at different levels. Protocol conversion mechanism makes application operation smooth. See, if protocol conversion is not happening automatically, then there will be lag in the operation. And as if there is undefined lag in the operation, real-time applications are not suitable for IoT. Right? But in practical and in basic practice, what is happening? Everything is happening real-time. And that is happening because of smooth transition of protocols when there is a switch from one protocol to another protocol, right? Some examples are listed here, like we are having Wi-Fi, Bluetooth for short range communication. For high bandwidth communication, we have Ethernet. Some frame formats are also there to have a communication on the internet, like IPv4, IPv6. For internet communication, we have TCP, UDP protocol. as well as with web URL access, we are having HTTP, HTTPS protocol, right? Now, unique identity, that is very essential feature of IoT. See, with every device, with every IoT node, or you can say with every IoT device, there is unique identity number. And based on that number, on the identification of that device can be done, right? Like as if you talk about internet communication. See, on internet also, IoT devices can communicate. So for logical addressing, we need to have IP address of that device. For physical communication, there can be MAC address of that device. For website-based communication, there can be URL identification number. Likewise, there has to have unique identity when it comes to communication on internet, right? So here, unique identity, that will be there with all IoT devices. That is also referred as unique identifier. And as I have told you, there can be IP address, URL, right? Those are the basic example of it. Here, IoT devices has intelligence interfaces in IoT ecosystem. So intelligent interface happens only if they know like to whom we need to communicate and who is communicating right now. And that is happening based on unique identity as per, you can say it is name, right? See, using unique identity, following issues can be resolved, like query of the devices, monitor their status, or control them remotely. So if you want to do each of these tasks, you should be having unique identity number, right? Now, let us move on to next characteristics. That is heterogeneity. See, heterogeneity explains how differences are there in devices, how differences are there in protocol, how differences are there in network. See, some networks are small, some networks are huge. There can be less number of devices in some region. There can be many devices in some region. There can be small distance communication in some region. There can be large distance communication in some region. Means, in terms of communication, in terms of network, in terms of solving issues of communication, there will be heterogeneity in IoT ecosystem, right? So heterogeneity, that matters a lot. It explains differences in between various IoT devices and platforms. IoT devices are based on different hardware, platforms and networks, right? And based on that only, you can say heterogeneity is there, and it has to be there. See, if you talk about Surat city over here in Gujarat, 60 lakh population is there in this small town, right? But if you go somewhere in Kerala, right, in Munnar, you'll be observing population density is very less, right? So there has to have heterogeneity when it comes to IoT operation. That operation happens in Kerala, same operation can happen over here in Surat, and same operation that can happen in Canada somewhere, right? The reason is IoT follows heterogeneity, right? See, IoT architecture should support direct connectivity in between heterogeneous network, right? As different size, different scale of networks are available in IoT ecosystem. When it comes to key IoT architecture requirements, then you should know scalability, modularity, extensibility, and interoperability. That matters a lot, right? Now, I'll be explaining you integrated into information network. The entire IoT system is integrated in information network only. The reason is Internet of Things. So here with internet, all the devices, means all the things are connected, right? So integration with IT network, that is very essential over here. See, IoT devices are integrated into information network, where IoT can be dynamically discovered in the network. See, all the devices that can be dynamically discovered, and for that routing algorithms are there, right? Here, interconnection of IoT devices makes IoT system smarter. And with respect to time, many devices are getting added, that even we have discussed, right? And here, there is an interconnection of all the IoT devices with each other via some network, right? See, rapid growth in number of interconnected devices makes IoT system more accurate. You should know, my dear students, nowadays, humongous growth is happening, number of devices are increasing, and based on that, more information is available, which makes IoT system more accurate, right? Now, let us move on to another parameter, that is scalability. You should know scalability is always required as many devices are added with respect to time, right? So system should be scalable. It is not like in particular region limited devices are possible. It should be scalable. It can be less, it can be more. Scalability is always required. So the IoT ecosystem is witnessing rapid growth in number of interconnected devices. As a result, IoT infrastructure must possess the capacity to accommodate this substantial expansion. Additionally, the volume of data generated within the context is very vast, necessitating appropriate data management strategy. See, as number of devices are increasing, it is but obvious data traffic will increase. So your network should be scalable over here. Otherwise, if data traffic cannot be handled over here, in that case, devices cannot communicate with each other. So scalability is very, very essential over here. Right. Next is security and privacy. See, as number of devices are increasing, everything is available on the internet. Security is a major concern. Privacy is a major concern. If privacy and security is not maintained, in that situation, we'll be observing system cannot be trusted by humans, right? But see, with respect to time, updates are coming. With respect to time, security protocols are getting changed. And nowadays, the systems are getting more smarter in terms of security and privacy, even, right? So IoT security and privacy are the paramount issue. This is the major issue that you can say. And that is what major companies are resolving nowadays by some updates even, right? So encryption, authentication, and regular updates are essential with respect to time, right? That is very essential with respect to time. Why? The reason is, without authentication and encryption, system is not that up to the mark, as everything is available on internet. Now let us discuss about last feature, that is automation and control. See, IoT automation and control makes industry efficient and provide more intelligent management. As in my earlier video also, I have told you, more than 50% of usage of IoT that is happening in industries. Why? The reason is, industries are getting efficient and it is having more intelligent due to IoT technology, right? Due to automation, IoT can autonomously perform some tasks. It can optimize the processes and respond to the changing condition without human intervention, right? And as we don't need more human intervention in IoT, IoT leads to more automation, which performs tasks in an efficient way, right? Automation enhances productivity, reduces operational cost, and streamlines workflows. Here, when it comes to remote monitoring, then that is getting easier due to automation and control. Management of connected devices, it is gaining real-time insights and enabling convenient control. So that is how things are happening with IoT system. So these are the varieties of features. I hope you have understood this. Please do subscribe to our channel. If you have any query, just place that in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this.